In administrative jargon, an unaccompanied minor is a foreign, under 18-year-old child not in the care of a responsible adult, father, mother, or close relative. In France, child welfare services have a legal obligation to protect these children. The same regulations apply nationwide, but depending on the region, they receive very different treatment. What does the law say? Upon entering French territory, anyone claiming to be an unaccompanied minor must be provided protection, shelter, and if necessary, medical care. Their unaccompanied minor status must be assessed within 5 and 13 days maximum. During this period also, they are to be provided accommodation and protection. All unaccompanied minors legally recognised as such remain under the care of the state until the legal age of majority. Paris is one of the regions in France with the most unaccompanied minors. In 2016, 2,005 were assessed by Child Protection Services. The system is overstretched, and contrary to what the law provides, the youngsters, traumatised after long and dangerous journeys, have no safe place where they can get some respite, recuperate, access healthcare, and obtain information on their rights. Some are even denied the possibility of having their request examined properly. In the humanitarian centre set up by the authorities, an initial 15-minute interview can be all it takes for the DEMI, the evaluation unit for unaccompanied minors, to reject their application. Applicants who manage to get an assessment interview then have to wait an average of 4 weeks for the decision, far more than the maximum of 13 days provided by law. During this time, they're put up in hotels where they receive almost no support. The percentage of applications rejected upon completion of the age assessment procedure is much higher in Paris than the national average, 80 to 85% compared to 50% elsewhere in the country. Once rejected, these asylum seekers are no longer entitled to protection. Presumed to be adults from the time they entered France, if they are unable to provide proof they're under 18, their only option is to appeal the rejection before the juvenile court. In Paris, the association AG supports them through this process that can take up to several weeks. Considered neither adults nor children during this time, they are in limbo with no protection. Many sleep rough while waiting for the court's decision. In autumn 2015, Médecins Sans Frontières began assisting refugees, first in the camps in northern France, then in Paris with a mobile health clinic and emergency shelter. A team is also working on setting up a day centre which will be opened to unaccompanied minors who are in transit, who have recently arrived, or who have been rejected by the child protection system. MSF will provide primary and mental health care and help the youngsters integrate state-run health services. The teams will also work together with other associations specialised in education and legal aid for minors. Lastly, MSF plans to provide temporary accommodation to 50 minors awaiting the outcome of their appeals or who are sleeping rough.